Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. Students, this video is for 7th standard students. Students, can you recollect the points that what we have been talking? Yes, students, we have been talking about electricity, current and its effects. In the previous classes, we have talked about electricity, current and components of electricity, the symbols of electrical components. Okay, students, and in this video I'm going to talk to you is the effect of current, heating effect of current. Students, what is the name of the chapter? What is the name of the chapter, students? Seventh chapter. Electricity, current and its effect. Students, we have talked about electricity, current, related matter to this electricity and current, you know, students. How the connections and components and what is the circuit, you know, up to here it is completed. And students, and some other points, if I miss, you just go through the videos, you will understand what are the points that we have talked in the previous videos, in previous classes. Students, its effect, mainly the effect of current can be divided into three categories. What are they? The effect of current can be divided into three categories. One is effect of light and effect of heat and the effect of movement. Students, electricity, current and its effects chapter, we have been talking about this, and here the effect of the current can be classified like this: light effect of current and heating effect of current and movement effect of current. Students, let us talk about light. Okay, lighting effect of current. Students, lighting effect of current. You know, current, it's nothing but electricity, right? Electricity is a form of energy that can be converted into light energy. Okay? Students, different lights we see. Some lights are bright, some lights are dim, dull. Okay? Students, there are different types of lights. Example, in your house, in our houses, you see what is this? Tube light and compact fluorescent light, compact fluorescent light, in short form we call it as CFL. Okay, and LED, okay, light emitting diode. LED lights, we usually use the word, right? I think you might have heard the word LED. LED. Usually call them. But what is the full form of LED, students? Light emitting diode. Light emitting diode. Okay. And you know, students, the tube light, it's very common in every house, and compact fluorescent light, if it is possible, I will display the image related to this CFL bulb on the screen. You can see that. And a light emitting diode is also, it's common, commonly we see nowadays, it's very popular. LED lights are used in every households. Students, these are very common lights that are used in every households nowadays. It's very popular nowadays. Okay, now before it, you know, students, we used to, normal bulb, we used to use a normal bulb, right, which is in like this. We used to see a normal bulb like this, right? There will be a glass chamber, filament, and a metal cap and terminals. Okay, the structure of bulb you have studied in your sixth standard. Okay, right? That's about that. And tube light, it's like a tube. And you know, the tube is with some chemical present, a gas present inside it, and that when electricity passes through it, that becomes bright. So that gives light, that's tube light. Compact fluorescent light is also same. Tube light, it's also same like a tube light, but image of CFL or compact fluorescent light, I'll display on the screen, you can see that. And LED bulbs also. Right, this is the light effect. Lighting effect of current. And what else, students? Next one is heating effect. Students, heating effect of current. Heating effect of current. Okay, students, one day what happened, you know, students, there is a bulb in our house. I wanted to replace the bulb. You know, the types of lights we have talked just before, right? Yeah, I have different types of lights in my house. I wanted to replace one normal bulb with CFL or compact fluorescent light or tube light, or I wanted to replace that normal bulb from the place where it is right now with other bulbs like LED you take or any other bulb. But once I went there and I touched the bulb, I couldn't touch the bulb because the bulb was very hot. Students, electricity passes through copper wires, through the bulb, and there is a special part that is lighting in the bulb, in the normal bulb, that is called filament. When the current passes through the filament, that gets very hot, that gets very heated, and then that emits that heat and light as well. Heat along with light. Okay, students? I could not touch it. The bulb was very hot, you know. And we see that some of the bulbs become very hot when electricity flows through it. Okay. And then heating effect of current. heating effect of current, students. And what else? Any other appliances we see? Yeah, induction stove. Sometimes we see that what? Bulbs get heated. And one more my live experience I would like to share with you. When I was in my college, I used to stay in a room and I used to cook my own food myself using electric heater. You know, the electric heater is with a coil wire. It's a coil of wire. And the coil of wire is fixed in a frame that's which is made up of a cement like frame. That cement or asbestos, or what do we call that? Plaster of Paris frame. You know, that's with some coils, grooves, and that filament or that metal part, coil of wire is fixed in that frame. And when the plug is on and when the current flow through it, when we make the current flow through it, what happened, you know, that metal, that coil of wire gets very heated. When it is very hot, you can see the color of it, and that color will be very, tell me, the color will be in red. That becomes very red. Students, the coil of wire, you know, it'll be like this. Yeah, this is fixed in a metal frame, or not metal frame, the frame which is made up of POP. Means plaster of Paris, and this end positive and negative terminals are connected with a plug, and when you insert this plug into sockets of switchboard, and when you switch on, the electricity passes through it, and positive and negative charges pass through this coil of wire. When electricity passes through it, this becomes very red and it becomes very hot. And so that we can use for cooking this, the intensity of heat produced by this coil of wire can be used to cook some food as well. Okay, usually the metal used to make this coil of wire is nichrome. Okay, in bulbs usually we use the filament that is tungsten. Okay, tungsten filament, and this coil of wire is made up of nichrome. So the intensity of hotness that depends upon the thickness of nichrome wire, the coil of wire. Okay, thickness that depends upon what? Thickness also. Okay, and that copper wire is there, no? This copper wire, this will not get heated, only this nichrome coil of wire is getting heated, right? So that is specially designed for that, and its property is like that. Okay, and heating effect of current is like this. And what else, any other examples can you say? Other examples, like, you know, we cook food on induction stove. And we use electric water heater. water heater, and what else? And iron, ironing clothes, ironing clothes. And what are the heating effects that are very advantageous heating effect of current? You know, different heating effects you just think of, you can get as you know, as many as you can. Okay, that's about that. And heating effect of current is done. Then what is the heating moment effect of current? Students, how you know current makes objects move? How current makes objects move? For example, electric motor, motors, you know, the construction of motor, if you see that the construction and electric motor and all, you will study in your air classes. But moment effect, you know, this we are talking about moment effect of current. See how the moment effect of current is. For example, you take motors, you can take very small motors to big size motor. And where these motors are used? Okay, to make something move. For example, you take vehicles. Vehicles, you know, students, electric motors are used in vehicles. Electric automobiles are nowadays are slowly becoming popular. You please try to understand moment effect of current. And current is produced by some source of current like batteries, and then that affects the motor, that makes the motor move, and then makes the vehicle also move. That is different story. And how and what else? If you take apartments, to go from ground floor to you know, top floor, there will be what? Lift, no? The moment of lift is also because of moment of effect of current. Current, effect of current. Current only makes the lift move. If the power is gone, the lift remains rest. Okay? So we have to understand the lift is also used, its moment due to the effect of current, students. Okay, students? And what else? You just think about the moment of different other objects. Anything else? Motors are used in different areas. So the water we are getting from the ground is also used, you know, motors, water pump sets. And, you know, yeah, it's very, very important, you know, moment of the objects by the effect of current makes so many, gives us so many comforts. Like electric fan you take. Electric fan is also moving due to the effect of current, right? So you can do it as a project work, students. Students, how you have to do is, you have to make a table with three columns. One column lighting effect of current, and one column heating effect of current, and third column moment effect of current. You have to mention the effects in which areas the current is in effect. You just mention it and do it as a project work, students. Okay, I hope you all understood this. Next, students, if we use this current in different areas. The current is not for free. Is it free? Do you think the current or electricity is for free? No, not for free. Current is not for free. It costs. How it costs, you know, students? How it costs? It costs, you know, if you observe electric bulbs, like, you know, electricity is not for free, it costs. And if you want to understand how it costs, you have to understand the amount of current used by. Okay, amount of current used by. How the current is measured. The units of current, you know, watts. And if you see some electric bulbs, on the bulbs that's written like W with, you know, some number 250 or 100 or some what, 100 and W, 250 or W or some number, okay, something X number for example, and W. What does it mean? W means watts. What is watt? It's unit of the amount of current used. Okay, units of the current. And if a household uses current 1000 watts per 1 hour, 1000 watts per 1 hour, then that is said to be one unit. Students, is this clear? If a household uses 1000 watts per 1 hour, then that is said to be one unit. You know, the one unit costs, for example, 2 rupees. Or 2.5 rupees, 2 rupees and 50 paisa, or else 3 rupees, etc., etc. That varies from state to state. For example, in Telangana, you ask your parents, you know, if sometimes, you know, a person from electricity department comes and scans that electric meter, that which is fixed outside wall of your house, you know, he holds a machine in his hand and he scans that reading of that units used by your house. Okay, so after it is scanned, he says that, you know, some amount, right? You please ask him next time when he comes, you know, you ask him what is the cost of unit, per unit, what is the cost? How many units are used by you? And then what will be the cost of, or what will be the bill or current bill? We usually use the word, you know, current bill. You know, what is the current bill? What is the charge of current used per unit? And then how many units you used? And what is the total charge that you are charged? Okay? Here that also you can do in you can do it as a project work, students. Okay, 1 kilowatt means, sorry, 1000 watts per unit. 1000 watts is equal to what? 1 kilowatt. 1 kilowatt, students. 1000 watts is equal to 1 kilowatt per hour. We usually write 1 kilowatt per hour. 1 kWh, 1 kilowatt per hour is equal to 1 unit. Okay, if you use 60 units, for example, 60 units 60 units. If each unit costs about 2 rupees, each unit costs about 2 rupees. What's your current bill now? 60 unit means? What is your current bill now? Tell me, 60 into 2. 60 into 2 is equal to 120 rupees is your current bill. This is just for example. In your textbook, it's given different. I am teaching you in an easier manner to understand. Okay? And this is about the students. And another part of electrical component is fuse. You know, sometimes if the power going high and low, that's called fluctuation of current. During this process, what happens, you know, students? Due to this fluctuation of current, the electrical appliances may get damaged, may get burnt. Okay? So to protect that electrical appliances, there is some other electrical component is used, that is called fuse. Okay, students? What is the symbol of fuse? You remember? This is the symbol of fuse. Students, symbol of fuse, it's fuse is nothing but a thin wire connection. Yes? Which allows the circuit. Okay, right, students? It's a thin wire connection. If there is high and low circuits, what happens? The thin wire gets very heated and makes it power goes off. When the power goes high and low, you know, the fuse is very sensitive to heat. When electricity passes through it with a certain limit, there will be no issue about it. But if the power goes more than limits, if power passes through it more than limits, what happens? It gets heated and gets broken. Then that goes fused. Okay? We call it as fuse gets disconnected. That gets burnt. And then that stops the circuit to protect other electrical appliances present in our house. Right? So this is how we can protect our electrical appliances used in our houses. And fuse is used in the place of fuse nowadays. There is another modern electrical component is invented, that is MCB. Miniature circuit breaker. So MCB is a modern alternate electrical component to fuse. Okay, and here if it is broken, manually we have to repair it. But here miniature circuit breaker is automatically resets, resets itself. And miniature circuit breaker, if the power goes high, it goes off. And even power goes low also, it goes off. So it's the advantage of miniature circuit breaker. It's modern electrical appliance used in every households nowadays. Before it, it's the replacement of fuse actually. Miniature circuit breaker is the replacement. Okay, it's replaced. in the place of what? Fuse. Once fuse is, you know, the thin wire connection is broken, manually we have to repair it. But here we don't need to repair manually. It gets reset itself, or we can do manually as well. Okay, there are two advantages here. We can manually repair, or else it gets reset itself. Okay, that's the use of miniature circuit breaker. And I will display the image of MCB and fuse on the screen. You can see and you try to understand. Okay, students, you have to write the understood points, that what you have understood out of this virtual video class, students. You have to write in a sentence form and present it in our WhatsApp group. Okay, I hope you all understood this chapter. Actually, this is the last point, you know, last subconcept of this chapter. And after this, the keywords and learning points, improve your learning section is there. You go through it, you will understand. You have to present it in our WhatsApp group, and you have to keep your notebook ready after writing it. Okay, students, this is for this video. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.